It's taken more than 1,000 people 3 years to plan and build, and now we're taking the first steps into our brand new home. This is Manchester City's training centre. Welcome to City Today. After the international break, the Blue Balloons are out and ready because this week the players have been taking their first look around. Well, the first team are going to be moving in over the coming months, along with the EDS and then the women's team. And one player who's only just got used to life at Carrington invited us along for his first journey in. Frank, big day today. How are you feeling about heading over to the new place?
Very excited, actually. Obviously, being fairly new to the club, all I've done is hear all the lads talking about it and being excited themselves. So I'm going into a bit blind, but I've heard so many amazing things. I think we're going to be very lucky, it seems to be working out.
Well, you've not had a chance for very long to go to Carrington. You've probably only just about found your way there and now.
Exactly, and we start again now, and from what I hear, this is bigger, and obviously probably take ourselves a little bit of time to get used to certain areas. I mean, I did love Carrington because there was a real kind of tradition and a really homely feel to it, but I think for a club like Manchester City now and the way it's moving forward so quickly, I think this is such an important part of the next stage of having a facility like this, not just for the first team but for the academy and to build for the future.
Elsewhere this week, Manchester City women are gearing up for their Continental Cup final against Arsenal. They ended their season on a high on Sunday with a 2-1 win over Chelsea. Jill Scott to open the scoring, followed by this screamer from Tony Duggan, sealing the 3 points and denying the visitors the Women's Super League title. They now travel to Wickham on Thursday and can't hide their desire for silverware.
I think it's going to be difficult. You know, again, it'll be on TV, it'll be a new occasion for some girls. You know, I'm lucky enough to have experienced the final before, but sometimes I still get nervous. So for them, I know how they're going to be feeling, but it's just all of us coming together as a team and helping one another and getting the best that we can out of that game and hopefully coming away with some silverware, because personally I think we deserve it for all the hard work that we've put into it on and off the field, and you know, it'll be nice for the fans as well.
The EDS have also booked their place in a cup final after winning 2-1 against Bury in the Manchester Senior Cup. Goals from George Glendon and Seko Fofana put them through. They'll now face either Manchester United or Bolton for the trophy. City under-18s came from behind against Newcastle to snatch a point and stay top of the Premier League North Division. A second yellow for Tom Holland saw them go down to 10 men, but they battled back, levelling the score at 2-2. And he set off armed with only his Twitter account and a cameraman, and now you can see just how far Chappy managed to get in his last challenge. As part of his Challenge Chappy series, the legendary Kitmanton presenter appealed to fans to help him trek across the country. You can see what happened later this week on City TV.
Lip services.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
I can't go on camera. The police are looking for me.
Everywhere we go, we can't put anybody on film here. What's your name?
Joe.
This is Joe. So, Joe. We're with Joe. Looks a character. Fortunately, taking us to limb services, where hopefully we can get a truck, well, wherever from there, because it's south, M6, M1, M5. So things are looking up. Well,
I'd like to thank Joe from Norton's dropping us off at Knutsford here. And what's the best thing we can do now to get further?
Best thing you can do is just watch these trucks go up there for the vans and cars. Tell the people what you're doing. And you should be no problem getting down there.
They're all going south for sure, aren't
they? They're all going south.
Well, thanks again, Joe.
Thanks, okay, lads.
Great to meet
you. Best of luck, lads.
Thanks for the trip. Thanks for the help.
No problem.
Thank you.
Son.
That's the latest from our brand new training centre here in Manchester. We'll see you on Friday.